Today, we're doing holiday specials. Mga recipes that when you see them or you hear about them, that equals celebration. Now, we're here at the Kuisen Experience and Design Studio in Makati. Kuisen Kitchen is the distributor of Pog and Paul. To me, Pog and Paul, I came across this maybe a few decades ago, and it's the most beautiful kitchen design I have ever seen, and they still are. Look at this, minimalist but very efficient. To start off with our holiday recipes, I'm going to make a roasted stuffed pork belly. Here are the ingredients for a roasted stuffed pork belly. 2 kilos of pork belly, some fennel seeds, grated lemon zest, rosemary, thyme, garlic, salt, pepper, olive oil, and rock salt. And we're going to start assembling. Make sure your hands are clean, okay? Let's start off with some lemon zest. Yan. We have some fennel seeds. Look at that. These are all dried if you want. If you have fresh, okay, no problem. Chopped garlic. Yan. We have rosemary and thyme. Pepper. Let's put half of this. Salt so that it doesn't overpower it. Yan. And then we have some olive oil. Yan. Mix all of these together very, very well. And this we will rub all over our pork belly. You know, when you get pork belly, there are two sides of the pork belly. Pork belly, kasi the fat is so thick. Now, I don't like that. There's another side of the pork belly that's lean, like this one, okay? Look at this, okay? Now, what I've done is I've gotten a knife, and I cut between the skin and the meat. Anything crispy, the enemy of that is moisture. So what you want to do is remove as much moisture as you can. How do you do that? I get a knife and I just puncture all over the skin. It doesn't have to go through all the way. Now, what I've done is I've separated the meat. I'm gonna have a challenge here when I start wrapping it, but make sure, like I mentioned, is your hands are clean. Okay, now what we will do is just brush this all over. Okay, so what we will do is this, okay? And then here at the bottom, we will do the same. Spread it all over, and lang. Now, what I'll do here is I'm going to just rub it with some salt, okay? For the skin, okay? The sides, I have some salt here. Very little lang, okay? Now, here, I want to, let's rub a little salt lang. And then, what we will do is we will just tie this with butcher's twine. Yan, ganyan. Okay, you want to start off with the sides first. Yan, ganyan, okay? Sides first. Sometimes it's challenging to cook talaga. Pero when you see the people enjoying what you cook, parang that's the reward of any chef or any cook. And you know, the purpose of tying it together is that you keep the meat moist. So the outside is crispy and then the meat is moist. So what I'm going to do, this leftover, I'll just rub it all over here. And then I'll put our pork belly. Here, look at that. So let me just pat dry this. Like I mentioned, here I am lecturing about moisture is the enemy of crispiness and then it's all wet. So let me just pat dry this. Anyway, it's olive oil. And 350 degrees for about an hour 15 minutes. But you'll see naman you bounce the back of the knife and it's going to be really crispy. Okay, so what I'll do is I'm going to take this to the oven and bake it. Oh my, oh my, oh my. That's beautiful. Wow. Look at that. Wait, I have to go back and close the oven door. But look at that. Oh my gosh. The more you allow the pork belly to breathe, it's going to become more crunchy. While it's hot, it's not that crunchy yet. So let it breathe and it's going to be more crunchy. So good. Look at that. So there you have it, our stuffed pork belly for our family get-togethers and reunions or any parties or festivities that you have. Up next, your family is going to love another classic Filipino pork dish, Lechon Paksiw. Stay tuned to Casa Daza. Every time you mention lechon, that equates to celebration, Christmas, New Year, basta parties, di ba? Now, when you have a lechon, it's impossible that you will not have a lechon sauce. But me, I'd like to teach you how to make a lechon sauce from scratch just before we make our lechon paksiw. For our lechon paksiw dish, we have oil, garlic, onions, leftover lechon, whole black pepper, soy sauce, bay leaves, liquid seasoning, lemon soda, brown sugar, and our lechon sauce made from scratch. We will need oil, garlic, onions, finger sili, liver spread, salt, pepper, vinegar, water, brown sugar, and bread crumbs. Okay, let's start. Cooking oil. You know, there's nothing like a good lechon sauce. So let's saute some garlic first. Okay, so we add in our onions after our garlic. Okay, so garlic and onions. Then we're going to add some finger sili, chopped finger sili. Not much, but this will add flavor. So, you know, every time I put this, I know many televiewers go, di ba? Sarap yan eh, but not too spicy naman. Tama lang. Okay. You know, this is beautiful, itong tabletop natin. Yan. And then, you can use also pork liver from scratch. The liver spread na ito. In Vietnamese sandwiches, yung bami, this is what I just used. I love liver spread. And then, mix. We add in a little salt. Okay, and pepper. Okay, and then vinegar. This vinegar, the moment you pour it, you cannot touch it because you have to let it breathe for about a minute or 2 minutes, no? Otherwise, it's going to be very sour. Then what we do is after we've let the vinegar breathe, we add in the water. Okay. Now we can mix. Then we add in brown sugar. A lot of brown sugar. Okay. Now let's taste this muna. Mix it well. Make sure that your sugar has melted and blended. And then, let me taste. Let me taste. Uy, okay ah. Now what I will do is I will thicken this using breadcrumbs. Okay. Yan. Yan na yan. And they will just simmer this until it becomes nice and thick. And then we have a delicious lechon sauce from scratch. Okay, look at the sauce. It's nice and thick already. It is peppery, mildly spicy, And what we're going to do now is we're going to make a lechon paksiw using lechon sauce we've made from scratch. We're done with our lechon sauce. What I will do is I will set our sauce aside. Yeah. I'm going to use the same pan. You know why? Because I'm going to saute here. We're going to use the same lechon sauce anyway, diba? So, cooking oil. We'll start sauteing garlic. Okay, now we're making our lechon paksiw. Okay, onions. Yan, garlic and onions. But then again, when you have leftover lechon, which rarely happens, is the lechon paksiw naman is ano, the skin is chewy, but so delicious also. Okay, so let's saute our paksiw or leftover lechon. And then whole black peppers. Diba sometimes when you bite into a lechon paksiw and there are whole peppers, sarap. Diba? Yan. Soy sauce. Mm-hmm. Seasoning liquid. Okay. Bay leaves. Actually, yung sugar, I have sugar, but you don't really have to put that much anymore, no? And then our lechon sauce. Careful, careful, careful. Look at that. Look at that. Brown sugar. Okay. Mix. Mix that very, very well. Yan na. So, last ingredient I'm going to add is lemon soda. Yan. Just mix all together. And what's important is you taste, di ba? You remember our lechon sauce was peppery? Let me check the sauce. Nako. You know the problem with this? With the maybe 2 spoonfuls of lechon paksiw, mga 6 cups of rice. But so, so good. This is it na. Now, what I want to do here is the skin, which was once nice and crispy, I'm going to make it soft and chewy naman by simmering this. Leave it. Siguro mga 30 minutes. Okay? There you have it. For our festive dishes, lechon paksiw with lechon sauce from scratch. Surprise them. Bring it to your next family reunion. Magugulat sila. Up next, I'm sharing my recipe for pinaputok na tilapia. Stay tuned for that on Casa Daza. Every time we have a get-together, diba, we just had lechon paksiw, diba? So something medyo, we look at it, it's so delicious but unhealthy. Somebody will suggest, why don't we have something healthy naman? So in this case, our healthy dish to balance all this guilt, siguro, if you want to call that, is pinaputok na tilapia. To prepare pinaputok na tilapia, we will need plapla, large banana leaves, garlic, onions, ginger, green mango, tomato, salt, pepper, liquid seasoning, and batis or fish sauce. Okay, so here we have some garlic. We're going to stuff this into the tilapia. We have garlic. Okay. We have onions. Yeah, and then little ginger lang, chopped ginger, because ginger has a tendency to overpower the dish, di ba? So, a little of this lang. Now, this ingredient is not usually in the filling of the tilapia, pero I said, why not? So, I put a little green mango. And then we have tomatoes. Okay. And then, I have some seasoning liquid. Okay. And then some salt and pepper, which I'll mix together. But anyway, going back to what we're doing, Okay, salt and pepper. I'm going to add this to our, this is going to be our stuffing eh. Okay, but you know, it's going to be flavored with liquid seasoning already. Then we will just mix all of this together very, very well. And you know what I've done? I've gotten a large tilapia from the palengke. What do you look for when you want to get fresh fish? If you look at the eyes. If the eyes are red, tika mo na, that's not that fresh. So you look at the eyes, that they're bright and everything. But what I've done normally is they just cut open the fish and remove the insides and the gills, di ba? But what I've done here instead, I've gotten the back and I remove the bone from the back. Okay, look at that, oh, look at that, see? So it's kind of boneless already, but tilapia naman is, you can easily identify the bones. So now, before I start, what I'll do is I'll put mga slits lang. And the purpose of this is just so that the flavoring or the seasoning will penetrate our tilapia. In this case, but this is the one that we will use to season our tilapia. But anyway, okay, this is what we will do. Yes, we will start by stuffing our tilapia with this filling. Can you imagine the already? The touch of green mango. Yan, look at that, huh? Okay. And then what you want to do here is brush it with patis. Okay. Brush it with patis. Okay. Just like that. You know, there are three ways of cooking this, no? You can bake it, which is what I'm going to do. You can fry it in a little oil, or you can broil it in charcoal. Okay, now, this is our tilapia. Okay, stuffed already. We're just going to fold it like this. Okay. And then tie the ends. We'll just tie the ends. We have a butcher's twine. Yan. Yan lang yan, simple lang yan. There you go. Now, here again. Okay, so what we're going to do is just tie it up like this. And that's done. Okay, I'm done with one. Okay, and the second one, let's do this. Okay, let's brush it muna with patis before I put the stuffing in, no? So, you know, here you will notice that the bottom of the tilapia is sealed. So you don't have to worry that it'll go and escape from the other side. It won't, no? Yan. Okay. Yan. Okay, so you already know what I'm doing. So let me just put this in our baking dishes and we will start baking. Sandali lang to, mga 15-20 minutes lang ito. And you know, there's a very, very minimal chance that you overbake this. Why? Because it's covered. Okay. We are ready to bake. Okay. Anyway, what's key there is the filling, you know? Yo, look at that. Look at that. Okay, we'll just flip this over also, yan, para sealed siya. Okay, yan. De sayang, eh. I don't want the juices to come out also. I'm gonna bring this to the oven, ah. Okay, we're done. We are done. Look at that. You know, the one that really first stands out are the banana leaves. Look at this. Aha! Look at that. Oh. Look at the juices. Oh. Ooh. So all the juices were caught at the bottom with this delicious pinaputok na tilapia. You know what? Don't leave because I'm going to taste all the dishes. You have to try this at home. Everything is delicious. Wow, look at that, oh. Mmm. Mmm. When you see dishes like this, you cannot but help think of celebration, family get-togethers, reunion. Look at that. You have a roasted stuffed pork belly. A lechon paksiw made with lechon sauce from scratch. And then we have pinaputok na tilapia. I have here rice, which I hope I will not touch if I'm strong enough to resist. But dishes like this, how can you not, diba? But anyway, let's start with our pinaputok na tilapia. I put a touch of chopped mangoes. Yeah, no, look at this. Oh, wow, look at that. Yan. Just by looking at it, no? Ayan, look at that, look at that. And your stuffing becomes your sauce. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Mmm. You know what? There's a little kick, little spice. The fish is very moist. And the flavors of the stuffing talagang blend together. Wow. You know, the dish is very, very simply made, but it's very tasty. Yung subtle taste, but very good. Sarap. Woo. Oh my. Ang sarap niya. The crunch from the onions and the tomatoes, very good. Let's go for our pork belly. Ito naman pork belly. The life of this, apart from the flavor of the herbs and spices that we put, is the dripping. Yan, dripping. So, I want you to listen to this, huh? Yeah. This is the skinny. You hear that? You hear that? This is not your typical Cebu lechon pork belly. This is medyo Western. Ang sarap. It's different. It's crunchy. It's moist. It's flavorful. It's different and it's delicious. Wow. Sorry, ah. Rice. It's very good. Mmm. This is so good. Now, ito, I was waiting for this, yeah. Yung lechon paksiw, I was looking at the skin, which used to be crispy. Now, we're going to have it tender and sticky. On the side, rice. Wow, look at that, oh. Mmm. Mmm. The skin has a little crunch pa. And a little chewy. And it's gelatinous and it is so, so good. Mmm. If you don't mind, I'm going to continue eating. But before I go, I'd like to thank my friend, Happy Umpaw Ko. My happy home. Look at their beautiful plates. And you know, when it comes to decor, nobody will be happy. Happy, thank you. You have to try this at home. Celebrations, reunions, festivities. Everything is delicious. Try it.